So, dear students, now having done with the introduction to the strategist, we did about the author, the background, and about the title. Now we'll go into the story. Okay. Now, once again, before we go into the story, I'd like you all to be introduced with the characters of the story. Okay. First one is Mrs. Jallet. Okay. Now she is the one who organizes the party. She is the party hostess. I said, in the introduction, like the rich children, they used to go for parties in common places. So she is the one who organizes this party, and for where she has invited these children, the rich people. Okay. And then among the boys, we have Rolo. Now remember this name. He is the main character of our story. He is the strategist. Okay. And how he becomes a strategist, we'll find it out later. Okay, when we proceed in the story. And now we have Jack, who is Rolo's friend. Okay, Jack. And we have Rosley's, see here, Rosley's. These are Rosley brothers. There are two, elder and younger. So Rosley's, Rosley brothers. And they have also with them the cousin. Okay, their cousin. Now why have I written here versus Rolo and because this particularly Rolo and this Rosley brothers, these two brothers, they were childhood enemies, not childhood friends, enemies. They were rivals. They were always against each other. Okay, so they always tried to find an opportunity to disapprove each other in order to outsmart the other. So this is how they always look for an occasion. So therefore, they were always rivals with each other. Okay? They were rivals with each other, this Rolo and Rosley's. And Jack always supported Rolo, and then Rosley's was supported by their cousin. Right? So this is one. And among the girls, we have Dolores, and we have Agnes Blake. Okay? So these are the characters. There are more children. In total, actually, there are 14 children. 14 children. Okay, but among them only these names are mentioned in the story, if you find it. Okay. Okay, now the story begins with Rolo. Now Mrs. Dallet has organized a party and all are invited. And now Rolo is coming to the party in his carriage. Now what is this carriage? You know this, no? Carriage means, you can see also on page 72 of your book, it's a kind of a cart which is pulled by a horse. No? You might have seen in the movies and all. Olden days, there were no vehicles, so they used carriages, okay, pulled by the horses. Only rich people could afford these. So as Rolo was coming in his carriage for the party, he was in a way already in his mind, he is evaluating how the party would be. He's saying that there must be around 10 girls and maybe around 4 boys, Rolo, Jack, Rosley's, and if they bring their cousin Rosley's, then we'll be 5 boys and around 10 girls. So he's already in his mind playing, and he said that so today the war will be, the battle will be against 2 against 3, okay, just Rolo and Jack as a team and Rosley's and cousin. So against 3. It's a battle of any. No? So this is how he is going prepared, mentally prepared for the encounter with Rosley's and others. So this girl is Agnes Blake. So but as Rolo reaches, he's getting out from his carriage, he hears Jack's sister, well, the name is not mentioned. Now she is apologizing to Mrs. Jallet, party hostess, saying that so sorry, my brother Jack could not come for the party of some unavoidable situation at home. So he couldn't come, I'm sorry. So apologizing his sister. So Rolo overhears that and he says, oh my, that means today I'm alone. And he sees that the Rosley's have brought their cousin. So he makes up his mind, he says that, oh, that means today will be 1 against 3. My rivals are 3 and I'm only 1. So I have to manage my myself. With that intention already in mind, he enters the room or the party room. No? Now once they reach, they begin a game. No? As they are not dieting, they don't go for eating. They always boys versus girls, boys to one side, girls. So, what kind of game they wanted to play? It was the elder brother of this Rosslis. The elder brother suggested that we'll play a game of naming a word, and he tries to explain. Like, the boys first will go to the other room, there's a library there, we'll go inside and we'll think of one word, and we'll come out and we'll hint to you. And with that hint, the girls must be able to identify what word is that, which word is that. Okay, so that was the game. So the boys went in, the library, Rosli's cousin, and Bhuru alone. I mean, it's very, very awkward. He feels very awkward because he's alone. But anyhow, he can't avoid that. So they go inside and they decide upon one word, that is camel. Okay, camel. And they come out, and actually they were supposed to hint, give some hints on camel, but this cousin of Rosli's, he was a foolish fellow. He came out and he blatantly said camel instead of giving the hint. And at that we see Dholer is saying, you stupid fellow, you go to the rules of the game. Now again you go inside and you look for another word. You shouldn't say the answer. So that is how they are playing. But out here our Roro plays a little bit tricky. He says that actually we did not mean camel. We had not decided upon that word camel. Actually we were talking about dromedary. Now dromedary, the meaning of dromedary is also given in a book, a dictionary you can use. It is a one kind of camel. Okay? It's a from the camel family only, but it's not exactly camel. So actually we were meaning dromedary, it wasn't camel. So he's trying to actually outsmart the girls. But somehow this Roro is playing a trick. But Dolores was very smart. She said, no, that won't do. So again, they have to go inside and they have to decide upon another word. Okay? So they get in and they are looking for some other words, like if you look in the book, then mustang, or they look for quagga, or like this. Somehow they are playing the game, the boys and the girls. Okay, they are playing the games. And suddenly they are called for supper in the middle of the game. Okay? They are called for supper. A dinner. Now, when they came for the dinner, Mrs. Jarrett offered them fruits first. Okay? Peach. Now, Mrs. Jarrett had one unique, a peculiar kind of habit that she wanted to take this party as an occasion to teach this student some lessons also. Anything. So she would offer the food in such a way that it is not too much for them, at the same time it is not very, very less. She wanted to teach the balanced diet also to the children. Okay. She wasn't a miser, but at the same time she wasn't an extravagant also. What is an extravagant? It's the person who spends unnecessarily too much. So she tried to keep a balance. So therefore, there were 14 children and Mrs. Jarrett keeps 16 peaches. Okay, on a plate. And that plate is passed over. One by one, they are picking one and passing. Now these Rosslyn brothers, they are crooked fellows. These three brothers, they, two brothers along with their cousin, they pick up this peach each. One is they keep it in the pocket and one is in the mouth. So with this, the plate, nobody observes that, only this Roro who noticed that thing. Okay? So that plate rolls, and when it came to the last, when Dolores and Agnes were left, but there was only one peach on the plate. Now who to eat? So it was Agnes. Agnes was a fat girl and she loved eating. So she immediately picked up and she put it in his mouth. So her mouth. So Dolores had to go without the peach. So somehow they are doing, they are eating, they are chatting and all. Now in the middle of the eating, the dinner, Mrs. Jarrett suddenly remembers, oh, actually I had called or invited even a conjurer for you all to entertain. Conjurer. Steve Angel, and you know, Angel is a magician, you know, who has some magic tricks to show. But at the last moment, he said that he won't come. Okay. So therefore, if any one of you know magic, then at that moment, Rolo. Or if nobody knows magic, then we will start with the recitation. Recitation of the poems or whatever you want, we will start recitation. But recitation, no children want it. So therefore, Rolo gets up and he says, I know some magic tricks. Okay. And then he gets up and he comes in front of the audience and says, you might have seen the conjurers or the magicians taking out some things like coins, the cards, the small, small things from the people, from the ear, from the nose, the mouth of the people. But now today I am going to take out fruits from the people. Right? So he just stands there and he goes towards this Ross beach and cousins, and immediately he puts his hands in their pockets and takes out these peaches which were hidden there. Right? No, because nobody knew that they had kept in the pocket. Okay, only Rolo had seen that, and he takes advantage of that. Now, Rodley's and the cousin, these three are in a fix. Now, they couldn't say that we already have it in our pocket. It's not a magic. Because if they said that, then it would be clear that they had stolen that and kept it in the pocket secretly. No? So, in order to avoid that, they kept mum, they kept silence. So, Rolo took that as an opportunity to outsmart them, put them down. See how his plan or his strategy worked in order to fight against or in order to outsmart his rivals, right? So with that, after that, actually Rolo wanted to go home, you know, because they finished eating also. But again, he was stopped. Okay, and they started a new game. You know, another, the younger brother of Rosalie said that now we'll play another game. And that game is like we'll go inside the library like boys against girls, and then we'll think of one historical person, okay, historical person, and we'll come out and we'll act like that historical person, and you'll have to identify which person is that. Okay? And at this again, Rolo now, the strategist, he plays a last. Finally, he wants to outsmart even the girls. So he pretends to be leaning around this Rosalie's, his companions, okay? Actually, and he whispers, pretends to be whispering, but loud enough for Agnes Blake, who was just sitting there, to hear. He says that, okay, first we'll go inside the library, and then before we think of one historical person, first we will finish up with that chocolate which we have kept there. We will eat them up. Then we will think of. Okay. Now, when Agnes Blake hears that, she stands up immediately and says, no, now it is girls' turn to go inside the library and think of the person. Because they have already done it the previous day. So Agnes, along with some of her friends, they give it to the library. Okay. Not with actually to think of the historical person, but with the primary intention to get that chocolate. Okay. So they go inside. And Rolo is very, very happy because there's no such thing called chocolate inside there. Okay? And Agnes Blake, they from outside all others, Rolo, Jack, and they, these people could hear Agnes and her friends too, who were shifting the table and chairs here and there, looking for that chocolate, but they did not find the chocolate because it wasn't there. It was the trick, the plan of Rolo to outsmart the girls as well. Okay, and he succeeded. After that, Rolo is satisfied. He's very happy. Okay? Then he asks for leave from Mrs. Jalla, the party hostess, and he leaves. The last sentence of the story he says, it's been a most enjoyable evening. Thank you, Mrs. Jalla, said Rolo to his hostess as he walked towards his waiting carriage. He goes very, very satisfied and happy. Because of his planning and because of his strategy, he is able to outsmart his rivals Rodley's, and also he is able to outsmart or fool his opponent and his Blake, you know, the girls. So actually, he is the winner, he wins in all aspects, right? Okay, so this is the story. Okay, now you see how Rolo is playing a strategy, is playing the plans in order to win, in order to be successful, and he is. Okay, so for us all, the personal learning or the teaching that we get is that all of us need to have some strategy in life. We got to have some plans for us in our lives, right? There's a saying, you know, if we fail to plan, then we are actually planning to fail. Therefore, we have to have planning for our life, okay? But it is not that we plan, we make strategies in order to hurt or harm others, in order to outsmart others, in order to criticize others, but for our own betterment, for the betterment of our families, right? For the betterment of our society, for our nation, it is good that we plan things already in advance, okay? So that is a personal, subjective note that we all of us can have for ourselves. So, stay home, stay safe, have a good time.